Let's take a look at network techniques in the form of explained objective questions and answer, and the subject that we are dealing with is construction planning and management. So let's move to question number one. Question is saying event is an element of network which denotes, and the options are saying an important activity, initiation of an activity, completion of an activity, and initiation as well as completion of an activity. See, event is an instant of time that denotes either start or completion of activity, that is either initiation or completion of an activity. Okay, event neither requires any resource nor any time period. See, in this given diagram, we are having event as 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, we just said that event do not require resource nor it requires time period, but activity does. Okay, activity requires resources, materials and time for their completion, also for their progression, but event doesn't. Okay, in this network diagram, event is 1, 2, 3 and 4, and PQRS are the four activities in the network diagram. Okay, that's why option D is the correct one. It is initiation or and as well as completion of an activity. Alright, let's move to question number 2. Okay, in a network diagram, one can identify an event as an arrow or an arrowhead or an arrow length or node. See, whenever you are provided with a network diagram, you can identify an event given by or denoted by a node. Okay, and a node can be represented by a small square or an oval shape or a circle. Here, events are these nodes: node 1, node 2, node 3 and node 4 are event. Okay, whenever you are provided with a network diagram, just look for the nodal symbol which can be represented by a square or oval or a circle. Okay, let's move to question number 3. In a network diagram, tail event is known as final event, start event, intermediate event, or none of the above. Let's find out. See, when we are saying that an event is an tail event, is a tail event, then you have to look for an event which is making some activities, okay, which is giving rise to some activities. See, tail event is also called as start event, from which activities are arising, from which activities are taking place or starting. Okay, and opposite of that is head event. Okay, head or tail, start or final. Okay, head event is the final event at which the event is being the head of the diagram and activities are getting progressed over to that event. Okay, remember that tail event is start event, head event is final event. Okay, therefore in a network diagram, tail event is also known as a start event. Okay, let's move to question number 4. Identify the dual role event from the following diagram. Okay, let's go to the diagram. See, we have the diagram here and we have to identify the dual role event or events. See, when we are saying that an event is dual role, we have to look for an event that has both incoming and outgoing arrows. See, here this event number 10 is tail event. Okay, here event number 14 is head event. Okay, this is the starting event or tail event, this is the ending event or final event or head event, and in this we can directly see event number 11, 12 and 13 are those events that are having both incoming arrows and outgoing arrow. Okay, also for event number 12, incoming, outgoing. Also for event number 13, incoming and outgoing. Two incoming, one outgoing. Therefore, this specific event 11, 12 and 13 are playing the role of head as well as tail for some activities. They are starting point as well as ending point for some activities, or they are having incoming as well as outgoing arrows. That's why we call such event as dual role event. Okay, they are having both the roles. That's why ऑप्शन डी वी आर गोइंग टू टिक बिकॉज 11, 12 एंड 13 आर द थ्री इवेंट दैट आर ड्यूअल रोल इवेंट. ओके ऑप्शन डी इज द राइट वन. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इज सेइंग फॉर द फॉलोइंग डायग्राम सिलेक्ट द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट और स्टेटमेंट्स मल्टीपल आंसर्स कैन बी देयर. वन इज अ ड्यूअल रोल इवेंट. ओके वन इज अ ड्यूअल रोल इवेंट इज इट. येस इट इज हैविंग इनकमिंग एरोज एज वेल एज आउट गोइंग एरोज. ओके पी क्यू आर द इनकमिंग एरोज एंड एस इज द आउट गोइंग एरो. दैट्स वाई वन इज अ ड्यूअल रोल इवेंट इज अ करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. देन पी क्यू एंड आर आर पैरेलल एक्टिविटीज. येस दीज आर पैरेलल एक्टिविटीज बिकॉज दे आर हैविंग सेम लाइन ऑफ एक्शन एंड दे आर मीटिंग एट वन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ दिस इज इवेंट नंबर वन देन पी क्यू आर द थ्री पैरेलल activities that are conducted on the same timeline. Okay, that's why they can be called as parallel activities. Then activity S is in series with activity P, Q and R. Yes, P, Q, R are in series with activity S. Okay, they are coming in a series. Okay, that's why activity S is in series with P, Q, R. Means with respect to timeline, after P, Q and R progress and get finished, then S can start. And when we are saying PQR are parallel, means they can take place simultaneously. That's why the first statement, one is a dual role event is correct. PQR are parallel activities, it is also correct. Then activity S is in series with PQR is also correct. Now let's see the statement number 4, which is saying activities P, Q and R are independent. No, not independent, interdependent. Interdependency of activity PQR is not there. Activity PQR are isolated independent activities, not interdependent. Focus the word interdependent. They have no connection or they do not have any dependencies on each other's completion or each other's progress. That's why these three activities are independent, not interdependent. Therefore, when the statement is saying that PQR are interdependent, it is wrong. Therefore, we will have to look for option that says statement number 1, 2 and 3 is correct. And such an option is option C. Okay, got it? Now let's go to question number next. In a network diagram, a dummy represents. What a dummy represents? An unimportant activity. See, there is no such thing as important or unimportant activity. There exist activities, events and the proper timeline. That's why no such thing such as unimportant activity is there in a network diagram. Similarly, no unimportant event or process is there in a network diagram. Therefore, all the three options that are saying that a dummy represents unimportant activity or event or process is wrong. That is why we are going with option D, none of the above. Now let's see what a dummy is and what are the uses of dummy. See, simply speaking, dummy is used to keep a network diagram meaningful as well as logical, and a dummy is shown by a dash line, a dash arrow. Okay, a plain activity is shown by an actual activity shown by a complete full arrow, a straight line with arrowhead, and when we are talking about dummy, it is shown by a dash line. Okay, it also has arrow, but it is shown by dash line. Okay, see, when we are saying dummy is there, dummy is just kept to keep the diagram meaningful. In first example, we are having two events, 19 and 20, and two parallel activities are there, which are P and Q. Now see, from 19, two activities are emerging and they are getting completed, they are getting finished at event 20. But it is making the diagram complicated. See, activity P and Q's completion is aimed at a common event, okay, is aimed at common event, which is 20. Now, they have origin from a common event, that is event number 19. Now, to make the diagram neat and easy to interpret, what we have done? We have used a dummy over here like this, and the new diagram is still possessing the same meaning as in the previous diagram. Okay, but in the previous diagram, the network is looking complicated or it is not having a proper meaning. Now we have simplified and we have kept the neatness, cleanliness of the diagram by introducing a dummy over here. The meaning of the diagram remains the same even after introduction of dummy. And the second role the dummy can play is it has the indirect meaning, indirect logic interpretation over there. That is, in the second diagram, let's look at second diagram. Event N is there, P and Q activities are there, then after P and Q are completed, R and S can take place. Now we have to show that the activity S can start, it can progress only after completion of P and Q. What we can do? We can have a dummy over here which represents that P gets completed at event 11, Q gets completed at 12, and after event 11 and 12, the activity S progresses. Okay. And it has a meaning that S can start only after P and Q are complete. Okay, these are the two roles played by dummy. One is making the network diagram meaningful. Second is making the network diagram logical, or adding some logic or adding some hierarchy to the network diagram. Okay, hierarchy means preference or the sequencing. Okay, these are the two roles of a dummy. So that was all regarding network techniques. If you like the video, please press the like button, share it amongst your friend, subscribe for more such civil engineering videos for simplified learning. Okay, till then, take care, bye.